Hello and welcome back to my channel. So today I'm going to show you how to make a zoom eyepiece for your telescope. So basically you need two things to make a zoom eyepiece. The first thing is eyeship itself. You can use any eyepiece you have. I have a 4 element plus a lens. Second thing is negative lens. So I'm using a single element biconcave negative lens, but I will recommend you to use achromatic doublet negative lens. So in this video I'm going to explain and show you how to make such a lens. So this is how we are going to make our zoom eyepiece. So this is the eyepiece and this is the negative lens, and we are putting this together like this way. So as soon as you increase the distance between these two, you will get the magnification or zoom. Okay, so before proceeding forward, I want to tell you a few things about this project. First thing is, I am not going to use this eyepiece in my real life, and this is because I am using single element lens. You must use achromatic doublet lens for this project, otherwise you won't get sharp and clear images through your telescope. So I am not going to fool you by showing how the eyepiece is working great, but you can learn how to make a zoom eyepiece because the structure and the technique is the same for all. If you use multi-coated doublet lens for this project, then you will have a great result. So I am making this zoom eyepiece by using single lens which I only have, and I will show you how it works, and also I will show you the live demonstration of the lens. So this single lens will give me a zoom and a magnification, but it is not suitable for the astronomy purpose, and I am not using a lathe or any kind of machine in this project because I want to make this project as simple as possible, because most of the people don't have a lathe in their home. And I am not going to show you how I cut the pipe and the pieces because this is a very simple project and you can understand it very easily by explanation. As you can see, eyepiece is come off when I slide it too much, but you can avoid it by adding slot on the eyepiece and the pin on the other half. Okay, so let me show you how to do this. It is a little hard to do, but worth to do it. So this is how it works. The slot is on the eyepiece and the pin is on the other half. So when you move the eyepiece, the slot on the eyepiece will give the room for the pin to move backward or forward, but up to a certain limit, so your eyepiece won't come off accidentally. But in this setting you don't have a control over your sliding motion, and to do this you need to make your eyepiece more complicated by adding a tilted slot over the eyepiece. Let me show you how to do this. And it is always recommended that you add a slot both side of your eyepiece. Okay, so this is the example how you can make a tilted slot on your eyepiece. So this is my old project and you can see how tilted slot look like, and you can see it gives me a control over my sliding motion. So this is the simplest way that you can make your zoom eyepiece, and let's go and check whether this eyepiece works or not.